kind of, sort of, a little bit play Achtung Panzers, Operation Star. I'll roll the credits real quick so you can see the name, because I probably pronounced it like a derp. Anyway, it claims to be a company-level tactical simulation. There's a little bit more to it than that. So what I meant by kind of is that there are campaigns in this. I'm probably not going to do a full one. I'm probably not even going to do a half of a full one. But we will do some campaign stuff. So these are some of the campaigns available. This is Operation Star. There's also Kharkov 1943. And I think there might be one other Achtung Panzers game. So for this one, we have two different operations. We have obviously Operation Star, and then we have Kharkov Defense. Now, Operation Star, I'm pretty sure, was a group of German infantry had attacked and taken a town called Terranovka from the Russians. And then the Russians encircled the town, and I believe that the Germans were attempting to escape the encirclement to try to link up with the main attack force. And so that's what this campaign centers around. Terranovka, you can choose either as, Panzer Division. You can choose to play as the Germans or Russians, and then for this one, I believe, is the attack on Terranovka before. Maybe not. There's a whole lot of stuff there. So we're going to do the, the 6th Guard Cavalry Corps 201st Tank BDE here, which should be extremely easy because we're going to be fighting infantry. But never put it beyond me to fail at that. So this is our briefing here. You can see we've got our corps of tanky guys heading up this way and the recon units up north. We're trying to stop the 302nd Infantry Divisions from heading over this way, and their various platoons and attachments. They will have other attachments like mortars, tanks, probably not tanks, but artillery and heavy machine guns. So this is the campaign map, and we can't see their units. They can't see ours, hopefully. But we do have this recon unit up here, which you can see the circle is its, that's its radius of viewing. So we're going to move it up this way to see if we can see any of those German infantry units here. There we go. We can see that they have three units there. I believe this is a supply depot. And I can see that they have some units here and some units here. So we're going to move generally in this direction. They also have a unit here, which I can attack this turn. I may do that. Oh my god, it's triple Iskage! And we've got some unicorn riders here. I want to see if this is a... it is. So we're going to encircle and attack this unit en masse. Because I don't like it. Whatever this is, it is going down. Now these guys, they're going to get attacked, no matter what I do, unfortunately. Oh boy. And you folks are going to move due this way. Good, there's no unit here, fortunately, for them to attack, but they still could be attacked next turn, and we've got some reinforcements coming from this way, a great deal of them, but we need to stop this mass from getting this way, from advancing to the east. That's our goal. Now for the info, you see that it's snowing, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, the enemy's position and disposition is unknown, and there's our info. We've got 2 saber platoons, cavalry corps. I hope they're not actually on horses. I'm pretty sure they're not. Here we can see the different squads. We've got a Strekalov in reserve. It's a transport plane. I don't know how to use that. Some of our units are extremely low on supplies, but that's the Russian way. They'll probably craft some bullets out of empty vodka bottles. But these are the different platoons. Yeah, they're infantry platoons, and they have some artillery pieces as well. Here's our artillery as well, but they're in reserve right now. They'll become active later. We haven't had any casualties, losses, or medals, so all is well there. And we're going to take a look at this operation statistic. You can see that we've got less total units than them, I believe. But we have the advantage because we know what they want. Our job is just to stop them from getting it. So, again, there's what's supposed to happen. And so far, so good, except for I probably didn't want to do this part. I'm definitely going to do a lot of failing in this. I'm not particularly good at the game, but we're going to have fun with it anyway, right? So, let's get ready for the fun part. I just ended my turn. These are the moves that the enemy's making. They didn't attack any of my units here. They did move one unit here. Pardon me. And they moved some units over here. I can't see exactly where. There's our plane. Oh my god, I want to use that. But, the only combat we have is this one. So let's get, Total War style here. Total World War style, sort of. Hello, tactical battle map. So this is the deployment section here. You can see that all these moves that I was making on the actual map have been translated into this, up to and including the three different groups we have scheduled to assault this area. We have a unit of machine Maxim, 7.62. I thought Maxims were anti-aircraft guns. No, never mind. They're small anti-infantry machine guns. And over here, we have, thank God, unmounted cavalry units. With really silly hats. Someone put a donk on his hat. That guy doesn't have a donk on his hat. Anyway, we're going to be attacking this rail crossing, which has some bad men in it. So let's deploy our squads. You can select the platoons here. We have the three different platoons. Both of these are cavalry, and we have this one machine gun platoon. You can double click on any of these and select them, or you can select them at squad level, which I will be doing for the most of this, for the majority of this. I'll show you about the tactical points. These are capture and hold positions. They don't do anything, I don't think, except for allow you to sort of show the general progress of what's been happening. We're going to prepare for an all-out assault, though, using sheer numbers to overwhelm the enemy. I hope. Although it'll be difficult to considering I'm going to have to move these heavy machine guns, and that's not too easy. So I'll spread them a little thin, because we're going to move them probably first. But this group here, we're going to do the hammer anvil technique. It's a tale as old as time. The song as old as rhyme. I don't even know if that's what was supposed to be said there, but Beauty and the Beast! So yes, these guys will move forward, and everyone's gonna rotate like a hammer and then go smash. Except that's not actually right. I need penetration. Never mind. Okay, so it'll pivot around these machine guns. These guys will come over, and the machine guns will be the anvil. We'll have two hammers, one anvil. There we go. I'm a tactical genius. Except that my guys are all facing the wrong direction. So I will select all of them, and we'll have them rotate this way. There we go. Now they're all facing the right direction. One other thing. Let's take a look at the actual map here. And you can enable and disable the briefing. This is the intel that we've got. There's possibly some units up there, probably not. But we do know that these units are marching in this direction, or at least they have been. And there's somebody down here that we're going to be attacking, someone in this general area. So here's our line of attackers, and there we go. Let's do it. Alright, so our initial orders will be, I'll show you the move orders screen. Here we have move, assault, march, and defend. You can set priority targets. You can also set arcs of fire, which are really good for machine guns, so we could set up an arc of fire in any different direction and have them hold to that fire. You can set them to march in columns, rows, lines, etc. We're going to have them march in a line, and tanks in front, we're not going to worry about that because we don't have any tanks. Move fast or move slowly, i.e. hide. We're not going to do either. We're going to move these units forward, which I believe would entail that. That's just a which direction do you want to point thing. And we're going to move our machine guns forward as well, to the other side of this line of trees. And hopefully then, this is the leader of that group. It's good to have a leader with your armies, because they have morale and will panic if they don't have someone in a leadership position around. And we'll start these guys moving up that way. And hopefully we won't encounter the enemy too gosh darn quickly. So let's turn off that tactical map, because it doesn't matter anymore. And let's go. I'm going to go ahead and put it on fast forward mode. Now, this is what we, are commanding. A bunch of Mother Russia's finest vodka-swilling Nazi killers. Heading towards, hopefully, some kind of, at least Pyrrhic victory. And, here we go. We can see their unit tags now. Alright, so these guys are already moved, or they're still moving up. I think I may have made a big mistake, because I don't think I can move my machine guns now. Guys? Oh, these guys just didn't want to move. 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 Go. March? April? March! I don't really know a lot about this game, but apparently move doesn't work. March does for those kind of units. Got it. Alright, I don't want to use the roads. That one will tell them to focus on using roads. So we have taken the crossroads, but I'm going to go ahead and continue to advance those guys. And I don't see any... Uh-oh, we've got combats. Alright, you guys, I need to collapse right here as quickly as possible. Fuck the formations. Haul ass, because we are getting charged now. Fortunately, we're deployed already. Or at least we should be. Yes, we are deployed. And thus, a firefight begins. So I think we might have done okay here. I'm going to have you guys set your arc of fire. Like that. What are you doing? Get the fuck over here. Okay, we've also got some enemy units over there. We'll have you guys move this way. You guys are moving no formation this way. Fuck the formations. Just get over there and put your gun on someone. Put a donk on them or something. So they're still moving. Crazy bastards. Alright, who's got the Arc of Fire here? You have the Arc of Fire, but you're not firing. You must be out of range. There's not even anybody on the gun. Let's see if I can change this Arc of Fire. Oh, they're firing. They're just not firing in the right direction. You know what? Fuck the Arc of Fire. I don't know what that does, and I kind of don't care. There you go. Get some. My god, you guys are slow. Oh, I didn't tell them to move quickly. No vanda. Okay. Quickly attack this way. Set up right there. Actually, more like right there. You guys as well. There we go. Now they're moving quicker. Hopefully they'll get there in time to deal with this. Because, we don't really have a good line of fire on these, a line of sight on them. We can only see him every once in a while, so it'll be really difficult for my guys to hit him. That seems kind of loud. I hope that's not too loud, because I'm not willing to change the audio at this point. It's too late. Oh, yeah. Either he's gone to ground, or he's dead. Either way, our guys have picked up... No, he's not dead yet. Come on. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward this, because this guy's about to get smashed. And we can see some more enemy movement out there. Yeah, he's surrendered. Or is panicked and retreating. Actually been quite a few of them that are doing that. Okay. You guys deploy there. You deploy here. We're actually going to do a pincer attack on these guys, and I will leave my machine guns to cover us. hopefully this will do what we want it to. If I don't accidentally pause it, that is. I could move these guys up, but instead I think I'm going to move them around. Uh-oh. Oh, we're rushing. Never mind. Ha! Yeah, we still got some guys moving and such. And we're going to move these guys over here. No, we're going to move these two straight up the middle. You can stay and continue to provide fire. Yeah, don't hurry up or anything. God forbid you actually get to fight someone. They're getting there. It is a beautiful evening for a firefight, though, don't you say? I say. So it looks like they've taken a defensive position in this line of trees. Totally not okay with that. What are you going to do? Aha, there they were. Alright, some of my guys have taken fire. Oh, one of them just died. We'll give them an assault order and have them just, why don't you just prepare to fight right here? Take a sort of defensive posture and just start fighting. Because the assaultant grouping is on its way to fuck with these guys. And you know what? You're good enough. Oh shit! Oh fuck! Oh no 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 no. That's not good. Golan is in trouble because we were flanked. Did I mention that I'm not very good at this game? Please kill them. And these guys are now surrounded. The only good thing is that we've got these guys heading into the assault now. So we did a different kind of hammer and anvil. More like a ping pong table. An anvil. All I can do is hope that they hold out long enough for these guys to get up there and into the fight. There's probably a way to make these guys move faster, and I just don't know what it is, but, they're running. And we've got our heavy machine guns firing at the guys that are attacking our units here, so, awesome. Dylan, have you set up your gun, or are you dead? No, they never got to deploy. Oh no, they did deploy their gun, and they are indeed firing on the enemy. They're firing on the wrong enemy, though. I don't think they can see these guys from here. I'm gonna set their arc of fire. Shoot that way. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, they turned the gun. Attaboy. Because these guys I'm not so worried about. We've got this entire group here to deal with them. Okay, so that didn't turn out to be quite as bad as I had thought it might have been. We took some prisoners. Where was that at? Oh, these guys surrendered. Why? Because we flanked them? Like bitches? Something blew up there. Wow, that's a lot of bullets. I'm just gonna sit back and enjoy the show. Oh, that guy's dead. His buddy's hiding. We had some more enemy contact up here. So I'm going to have these guys assault in that direction while going. Why don't you forget your... We'll change your arc of fire here so that it's wider. And I'm going to have these guys move up. Actually, I'll have Kazulin move up. And that sounds good. Lifanov, why don't you move up as well? Are you moving? Yes, he's moving. Real goddamn slow. But he's moving. You guys are hanging out. So let's get you on the move. Looks like they're retreating to the rail crossing right now. And go ahead and quicken this one up. So I'm pretty sure Gullen's got these guys pinned down and, well, they're dead. only real issue I have is the timing of these two groups meeting up. So it looks like Gamma 2 was just taken from us. Yeah, this is a little combat log down here. So I'll have these guys head for Gamma 2, and these guys are heading for the rail crossing. We're going to split up a little bit. The thing has become moot. Moot. Because there's bad men there.